So here we are inside Adobe Animate CC. Animate was previously called Flash. So if you're using Flash, you should still be able to follow along with this tutorial. To start out, let's create a new HTML5 canvas. What this means is that we'll do some animations, and then Animate will automatically turn those into HTML code that we can use on a website. If you have an older version of Flash, you might not see that option. In that case, choose ActionScript 3.0 instead. But we'll go ahead and choose HTML5 Canvas for this video. So here we have the basic Animate interface. In the center of the screen, we have the canvas, which is a white surface, kind of like a piece of paper that we can draw on. Over here, we have the toolbar, and this has a number of drawing tools that we'll look at in a moment. And at the bottom, we have the timeline. Animation is a type of media that changes over time. Therefore, we need a timeline in order to create our animations. Let's start out by looking at how to draw and animate. So let's go over to the toolbar. And we'll select the rectangle tool. I'm going to click and drag on my canvas, and now I have a blue rectangle. Let's briefly look at some of the settings. So right here it says fill and stroke. So fill is a color that a shape is filled with. Stroke is an optional outline or border around the shape. So I can actually create a stroke by clicking here, and then I'll select a black stroke. And now the next time that I click and drag, you'll notice that there's a little black border around the rectangle. If I go to this selection tool that looks like an arrow, I can select the fill, or I can select the stroke. It selects one side of the stroke at a time. If I want to select the entire stroke, I double click, and that selects the entire stroke. And then if I want to select the fill, I can hold down shift and select the fill. But I'm going to delete that rectangle for now. We'll just work with the blue rectangle that doesn't have a stroke. I have other drawing tools as well. There's a oval tool right next to the rectangle tool. You can change the color, click and drag. Now I've got an oval. And I still have the black stroke around it. The polystar tool, that lets you create some more advanced shapes. Or if you want, there is a brush tool, so you can just do some painting. Animate is a vector drawing program. That means instead of working with pixels, it works with points, shapes, and lines. And so if you paint something, Animate automatically optimizes it. It turns it into a smoother line for you. There's also a pencil tool. In Animate, the main difference between the brush tool and the pencil tool is that the brush tool draws fills and the pencil tool draws strokes. And if you look over here, you'll probably also notice some other familiar tools from Photoshop. All right, so let's jump right in and take a look at how to animate. I'm going to use the selection tool. I'm going to click and drag to select some of the other things I've drawn, and I'm going to press the delete key on my keyboard, click and drag again, delete. I'm going to leave this rectangle here because the rectangle is what I'm actually going to animate. So I've got a blue rectangle at the top of the screen, and let's say I want this rectangle to move to the bottom right of the screen. So to do that, we need to go to the timeline. Notice these different numbers down here. These numbers are the different frames of the animation that you're going to make. It always starts on frame 1. But if we want to animate this, we need to create another frame. Actually, we need to create a special type of frame called a keyframe. Let me show you how to do that, and then I'll back up and explain what that is. So I'm going to click on frame 25. You can pick whichever one you want. And then I'm going to right-click and choose Insert Keyframe. Notice a black dot has suddenly appeared on frame 25. If I click back to frame 1, you'll notice there's also a black dot on frame 1. When you start animate, there's always an automatic keyframe on frame 1. So keyframes are the critical moments in your animation. So the first critical moment is the rectangle is in the top left corner. And then I'm going to click to frame 25. In the next critical moment, I want my rectangle to be down in the bottom right. So make sure the timeline cursor is on frame 25, where your keyframe is. And then click and drag your shape down to where you want it. Now watch this. If I click back to frame 1, my shape is in the top left where it originally was. But if I click down to frame 25, my shape is now in the bottom right corner. So pretty cool so far. We can test this animation. Go to the control menu and choose test. And because we chose HTML Canvas, it actually exports an HTML document for our test. And we can see our animation. It starts in the top left corner, and then we see it quickly flashes to the bottom right corner before going back to the top left corner. So this is actually a good start, but it's not quite there yet. What we're missing is what we call tweens. We've defined the key frames, the key moments in the animation, but now we want to ask Animate to draw all the in-between frames, which are called tweens. So I'm going to move this out of the way for now. And back in Animate, we are going to go back to the timeline. You might have to click on the timeline tab to get there. And now to create a smooth animation, just right-click somewhere between these two keyframes and choose Create Shape Tween. This is a shape, and so in order to create those in-between frames, we need a shape tween. Notice on the timeline we now have an arrow between our first keyframe and our second keyframe. This means that we now have a smooth animation. I can actually click and drag on this cursor and it will give me a rough idea what my animation is going to look like. Or I can go back up to the control menu and choose test again. Now, look at the nice smooth animation that we've created. I'm going to go back to the timeline, and just for fun, let's create one more keyframe. I'll go out to frame 40, right click, choose insert keyframe. And then I'm going to do something funky here. I'm going to actually delete this shape, select it, and hit delete. Notice that my keyframe is now empty. There's an empty circle there. That means that it's missing content, but that's okay. I'm going to go to the toolbar and choose the oval tool. Let's actually turn off our stroke. I'll click on that and just click the little red slash, and that will turn off the stroke. And then I'm going to draw a red circle in the top right corner. I want another smooth transition, so I'm going to click on an area between these two keyframes. We'll right click, actually, and choose create shape tween again. And now if I drag the timeline, watch this. The blue rectangle moves as we previously defined, and then it morphs from a blue rectangle to a red circle. So that's the great thing about Animate. All we have to do is define our key moments in the animation, and then Animate figures out all the in-between frames for us. So it's a really quick and fun way to make animations. Lastly, I will just go to Control Test again. And here it is in our HTML web page.